the head coaches, Marty Schottenheimer, Hank Stram, people like that, current coaches, and people outside the league, the networks, Gene Upshaw and others. So the team was people who worked for me at the NFL, people who worked at the club level, and people who worked with our partners. And most of all, apart from all those people, it's the fans.
Congratulations to Paul Tagliabue, a member of the Pro Football Hall of Fame Centennial Class of 2020. Here's a look at who else is joining him.
Some amazing names on this list. We knew about Cowher and Johnson coming in today, but Steve Sable, legendary filmmaker and NFL Films champion. George Young, executive. Of course, the players. We go through Jimbo Colbert and Harold Carmichael, Cliff Harris, Winston Hill, Alex Karras, Donnie Schell, who joined us on the show, and then the legends from a different era. Duke Slater, Max Speedy, and the great Ed Sprinkle. An amazing class. Congratulations to all those men and their families that survived them today.
Doesn't get much bigger than this, guys, here on the show. Good Morning Football. Such a historic day for the pro football world, and an honor to be joined by NFL Commissioner Roger Goodell here at the breakfast
table. Good morning.
Big day. Very glad to be here.
We are so,
very big day.
Yes. So glad and so honored, honestly, to reveal the guys who are going to be in Canton wearing those gold jackets for the Centennial slate. And you have some ties to the contributors, especially, of course, Steve Sable, particularly Paul Tagliabue. What do you feel and how do you feel about seeing him go in?
I think it's so well-deserved. It's a guy who made such a difference for the game. You know, Nate was talking about what he did for players and obviously the collective bargaining agreement that he forged with Gene Upshaw. I think when you look back at his career, he brought it into the modern era, and he really, not only from a business standpoint, but the game itself, you know, we expanded to 32 teams. I don't think we'd have a franchise in New Orleans if it wasn't for Paul Tagliabue's leadership. He was, you know, insistent that we continue to have the Saints there and through a lot of difficult challenges for that community. But we're really proud of that. And I think he understood how a community and the NFL have to operate together, ultimately. And I learned a lot from him. I was fortunate to be his chief operating officer. And I always say I work for the two greatest commissioners in sports, Pete Rozelle and Paul Tagliabue. Mm. And now see him in the Hall of Fame is pretty cool. Mm.
And you also have a connection with George Young, who for many years was looked at as one of the greatest executives in league history, also worked in the league office. So what was your connection to George Young, who many of us look at as the Giants general manager?
I laugh a little bit because when he left the Giants after his years with the Giants, he said, "I'm coming over to the ivory tower." That's how he used to say it. He never liked to come over when he was on the club level, and he joined us, the enemy, as they say. But he... you know, George was an extraordinary guy. He wasn't just a great football guy. He was just, he had a great sense of humor. But he goes all the way back into the 60s. He worked, you know, with the great Don Shula and Baltimore Colts. And he really, Pete Rozelle selected him, handpicked him to come in and run the Giants for the Mayors. Now, of course, the Mayors had to agree to that. But that was something that I think it changed the face of that franchise, and it changed the direction, clearly, of that franchise. And he was one that could do that. And so their success, I think, is a large part because of George Young. And I think the game itself, he helped us a lot on competition committee, a lot of other rules and officiating. He just was an ultimate football guy. If you want to talk about football, that was it. And he was a teacher. Ultimately started as a teacher. And he loved history. He loved the game. And this would be something that he would be so proud of. And it, again, well-deserved.
Very well-deserved. And there was a cheer that went up from Mount Laurel, New Jersey this morning. We could hear it all the way up here. We know this show, this network, likely would not be here without the pioneering work of Ed and Steve Sable in NFL Films. You were close with Steve. What is it like to see him now join his father in Canton?
Again, I never saw him happier than when his father got in. And I think now for him to be able to join them, I was teasing with somebody yesterday. I can't wait to hear what those two busts are going to be talking about at night. But John Madden will make them proud.
Of course.
Nobody loved football more than Steve Sable. Yeah. He was running NFL Films, but all he cared about was what showed up on the screen, He was a storyteller. Mm-hmm. And he wanted to tell the story. He didn't care about the business side of it. As a matter of fact, as soon as you started talking about budgets, Steve was out the back door. He wanted to tell the great stories of football and get behind it and tell about the people who played the game. And that, to me, was what made him so special. His passion and his drive to make sure people understood really what made this game, what makes this game so great.
Commissioner, we also saw the news last night that Luke Kuechly, one of our favorites, announced that he was retiring from the game that he loves so much. And I know that you know Luke very well. Talk about him as a player.
Well, I talked to Luke last night. He called to tell me the news. You know, he is such a spectacular guy. I mean, he's a great football player. I love watching him play. I've never seen a competitor like that. He's just every play, he's going at it. And he's even a better man. And that's, you know, he's contributed so much to the game. And so I think he's in a really good place. I think he says, I can't play the game at the level I want to play the game. And that just shows you what a professional he is. And said, I want to play the best. I want people to remember me that way. So I think he's great. I hope he stays involved with the game somehow, because I think he can contribute an awful lot. But I'm a huge Luke Kuechly fan.
Yeah, so are we here at the table. Now, Roger, this Centennial class, along with the five modern-day era individuals, will be announced at NFL Honors the night before the right. Super Bowl. Now, speaking of the Super Bowl, these four teams.
Here we go.
How excited.
Here we go.
How excited are you?
This is what you want to get to, right?
Yeah. Man, how excited are you for that weekend?
I love it. As a matter of fact, I usually figure out who's in the Hall of Fame class because as at NFL Honors, I go backstage and they're usually walking in.
Yeah.
So I'm finding out at the same time, which I love. It's part of it. But, you know, Super Bowl is, it just gets bigger and bigger every year and more impactful.
Yeah.
And this being our 100th anniversary season, I think we're going to have obviously, a great football game, which is where it starts and ends. But I think all of the activities around it, the halftime show, you know, it's going to be extraordinary. And we're excited. And I think we have four great teams.
No doubt.
And the fact that three of them weren't even in the playoffs last year is unbelievable to me.
How
and that to me shows the competition that we have in this league. I think any one of the four could win the Super Bowl. I felt that way last week of the eight.
Yeah.
And so, you know, we had seven of the eight last week that weren't in the playoffs last year.
How about that?
So the league is really at a competitive place where you can go from first to last quickly. Unfortunately, you can go the other way, too.
Mm-hmm. That's what it's all about, though.
Yeah.
We're broadcasting from the beach if you want to stop by our show down in Miami.
Sure.
Now, that's an offer. I appreciate that. Yeah. Unfortunately, they won't let me out of conference rooms and parties, right?
You'll be really, really busy. Thank you so much for taking the time to be here. It's a special
Thank you for all you guys do. This is a great honor for you, but it's a great honor for us. So thank you.
Commissioner Roger Goodell, everyone. More GMFB on the way. Will Selva has an update for us out in Culver City. Will, take it away.
All right. Thank you, Kate. Great having you there, Commissioner, in studio. The Browns have, of course, their head man in Kevin Stefanski. Now he'll be tasked with filling out his coaching staff. NFL Network's Jim Trotter reporting Stefanski has narrowed his candidates for defensive coordinator to Steve Wilks, who filled the role last year, and 49ers defensive backs coach and passing coordinator Joe Woods. As for the offensive side of the ball, Stefanski has loads of talent to work with, but his biggest task will be getting the best out of quarterback Baker Mayfield, whose numbers regressed in his second season. Stefanski says he has already briefly spoken with Mayfield and says the sky's the limit for his QB.
I will just tell you the skill set that our quarterback has is legit, and he's as accurate as they come. I think there's plenty of things that we'll do schematically to hopefully make life easier on him. And looking forward to the jump that this kid will take. I mean, he's such a young player. And the guys I've been around, when they put their mind to it and they start to grind on this thing and understand the whys in the concepts of that we're teaching, I really think this kid has a chance to take off.
Well, as the gang touched upon in New York, a surprise announcement Tuesday as Panthers linebacker Luke Kuechly announced his retirement in an emotional video on the Panthers' Twitter account. Kuechly still had 2 years remaining on his deal. The salary in 2020 would have been $10.8 million. Over his eight seasons in Carolina, Kuechly was a seven-time Pro Bowler and was named the 2013 AP Defensive Player of the Year. The Panthers owner David Tepper releasing a statement on Kuechly saying in part, quote, In my 2 seasons with Luke, I quickly recognized how special of a person he is, the respect he gives and garners from others, as well as the positive impact he has on his peers, is second to none. It's obviously going to be very difficult for all of us because we know that no player can replace what he's been for this organization for the last 8 years. His presence can't be replicated. In his announcement, Kuechly says he still